Good morning. The peace of Christ be with you. On this beautiful morning, we are gracious to the Lord who made all things new for us. And so I welcome you all, especially those who are joining us through the live stream, that through the power of the Holy Spirit and the technology provided for us, we worship together. And we welcome all our guests and those who are worshiping with us for the first time. We invite you to continue to sign in our friendship registry and pass it on to your neighbor as you greet one another through the love of Christ. There are a few announcements that it's listed in your bulletin insert. We have hands-on mission opportunity coming to us. Less than 2 weeks, I believe, August 13th. I know I'm going to be there, and so please show up. Sign up or talk to Rebecca, who's not here this morning, but there is the sign-out sheet out there. She mentioned it last week. It is a way for us to be in the community, not just spreading the good news, but also serving one another in Christ. So let's make a note. It's August 13th. It's a Saturday morning at 9 a.m. So we probably will be leaving from here. So we encourage you, if your calendar is free and you would like to serve the community, please do so, joining us to do it. Next Saturday is the rescue mission lunch that will be prepared at 10 a.m. here at the kitchen. So we encourage you and we give thanks to all those dedicated servants who come and help feed others in our community. Don't forget about the school supplies. When you are out there doing groceries, I already see signs that says back to school supplies. Let's think about those who can benefit from our generosity. And so this is what I have for you. Are there any other announcement from the community? We already know that the fence is being rebuilt, and we give thanks to Alan, whose dedication keeps coming every morning. He shows up and he's helping prepare, and now I see it is almost ready to be up so that we can keep our neighbors in good spirit as we worship here and serve the Lord. We still do need a support from those who volunteer to be part of the maintenance coordinating team. So if you're thinking about helping, all you have to do is sometimes just get a coat, make a phone call, and the work will be done. So we give you thanks for all the dedication that you do to serve one another in Christ. And that is all I have. If there are none, let us prepare our hearts and minds to worship the Lord together. Thank you.
Good morning again. Please join me in the call to worship. We are children of God learning to walk. Day by day, we are learning to be the church. God is a loving parent teaching us to walk. God loves us, leads us, and feeds us. There are many places we could be, but God has brought us here. God's steadfast love endures forever.
Not sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But we have a merciful God, a forgiving Father, who is ready to receive our confessions and be forgiven to us. Let us return to our God in confession, considering God's steadfast love. Let us open ourselves to God's mercy. Let us pray together. Nurturing God, you continue to lead us in upright ways on account of your love for us. Yet we do not always follow your call. We turn away from you and go our own way. Forgive us and return us to a rightful home in you. Hear us, O Lord, as we approach you from the silence of our hearts with our individual intentions. O Lord, forgive our waywardness and lead us back to you. Encourage our trust in your faithfulness and settle your faith in our hearts through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God's steadfast love endures forever. Beyond the cross, beyond the grave, beyond our sin, God's steadfast love endures forever. This is the good news. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Please be seated.
Watch us where we go, and help us to be wise in times when we don't know.
I guess my sermon is over. Well, I see there are lots of God's children here this morning. So I would like to invite Piper to come here with me. Okay. Hi, Miss Piper. How are you? Today we miss Miss Charlotte, but I brought something. Can you tell us what this is?
An iPad?
Oh, really? And then what does it say there?
The Runaway Bunny.
Oh! That's Bunny's Runaway?
Yeah.
Where'd they go?
I don't know. They just go somewhere.
They go somewhere to find food, I guess.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Where do we run away to? Where do you run away to?
My friend's house.
Oh. Ah, okay. Well, we have to find out where this bunny run away to. Can you help me find out?
Sure.
Okay. So here's a story. And this is, I'll tell you what this is about when we're done. So, once there was a little bunny who wanted to run away. So he said to his mother, "I'm running away." "If you run away," said his mother, "I'll run after you, for you are my little bunny." "If you run away, if you run after me, said the little bunny, "I'll become a fish in the trout stream, and I will swim away from you." Uh-oh. "If you become a fish in the trout," said his mother, "I'll become a fisherman, and I will fish for you." So here we have a picture of the bunny, mom, doing what? Fishing for the bunny. All right, let's see what happened. "If you become a fisherman," said the little bunny, "and I become a rock mountain high above. If you become a rock on the mountain high above me," said his mother, "I will mount a climber, and I will climb up to where you are." Uh-oh. So we have a picture of the bunny running after going to the mountain. Uh-oh, that's no good news. All right, let's see what happened. "If you become..." Oh, I don't really like these touch screens. "If you become a mountain climber," said the little bunny, "I'll become a crow house in a hidden garden." Oh. "If you become a crow house in a hidden garden," said his mother, "I'll be a gardener, and I will find you." Oh, this bunny, little bunny, can just run. "So if you become a gardener and find me," said the little bunny, "I'll be a bird and fly away from you." "If you become a bird and fly away from me," said his mother, "I will be a tree that you can come home." Is that what we are? How does God find us when we try to run away? You know?
Because he's everywhere.
He's everywhere. We can't really run away from God because he will find us, right? Well, today we hear a story about the prophet Hosea, whose children are like going away, running to their friend's house, going to school. They don't want to be in the house. But God says to the people of Israel, "I will find you. Even if you become so greedy and try to find excuses like the bunny, want to run to the stream, want to run to the mountain, want to run in the garden, God will find us." So wherever we think we're hiding from God, we are right in God's heart. And because God loves us so much, he forgives us and brings us back together. So guess what? When you run to your friend's house, guess what mom and dad does? They know where you are. Yeah, they will follow you, right?
Right.
Yes. So God follow us wherever we go.
Thank you, Miss Piper, for coming. Let us pray together.
Gracious and loving God, we thank you that you look after us. As we try to hide from you and run away, you love us so much that you send your Son, Jesus Christ, to come and find us. Help us to stay in your grace through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you for reading this with me, Miss Piper.
You're welcome.
As we prepare to hear from the scriptures, I invite you to join me in prayer. Almighty God, open our hearts by your Holy Spirit, that we may receive your words and show forth your grace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Old Testament reading is taken from Hosea, chapter 11, verses 1 through 11. The Lord says, "When Israel was a child, I loved him and called him out of Egypt as my son. But the more I called to him, the more he turned away from me. My people sacrificed to Baal. They burned incense to idols. Yet I was the one who taught Israel to walk. I took my people up in my arms, but they did not acknowledge that I took care of them. I drew them to me with affection and love. I picked them up and held them to my cheek. I bent down to them and fed them. They refused to return to me, and so they must return to Egypt, and Assyria will rule them. War will sweep through their cities and break down the city gates. It will destroy my people because they do what they think best. They insist on turning away from me. They will cry out because of the yoke that is put on them, but no one will lift it from them. How can I give you up, Israel? How can I abandon you? Could I ever destroy you as I did Admah, or treat you as I did Zeboim? My heart will not let me do it. My love for you is too strong. I will not punish you in my anger. I will not destroy Israel again. For I am God and not a mere human being. I, the Holy One, am with you. I will not come to you in anger. My people will follow me when I roar like a lion at their enemies. They will hurry to me from the west. They will come from Egypt as swiftly as birds and from Assyria like doves. I will bring them to their homes again. I, the Lord, have spoken."
The gospel reading this morning comes to us from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 12, verse 13 through 21. And it's in your Pew Bibles, page 100 in the New Testament side. Luke chapter 12, verse 13 through 21. Let us hear what the Holy Spirit is saying to the church. The parable of the rich fool. A man in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to divide with me the property our father left us." Jesus answered him, "Man, who gave me that right to judge or to divide the property between you two?" And he went on to say to them all, "Watch out and guard yourself from every kind of greed, because a person's true life is not made up of the things he owns, no matter how rich he may be." Then Jesus told them this parable. "There was once a rich man who had land which bore good crops. He began to think to himself, 'I don't have a place to keep all my crops. What can I do? This is what I will do.' He told himself, 'I will tear down my barns and build bigger ones, where I will store the grain and all my other goods. Then I would say to myself, lucky man, you have all the good things you need for many years. Take life easy. Eat, drink, enjoy yourself. But God said to him, you fool, this very night you will have to give up your life. Then who will get all these things that you have kept for yourself? And Jesus concluded, this is how it is with those who pile up riches for themselves, but are not rich in God's sight. And Jesus concluded, this is how it is with those who pile up riches for themselves, but are not rich in God's sight. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So here we are. We've heard two stories that are similar to one another. We have our lives, and these two stories, one of them reminds me about running away like the runaway bunny. But when I was growing up, my grandmother, whom I lived with, sent me to a middle school so far away from home that it took 7 hours by bus to get to where I am. I thought, boy, I would never return back to my grandmother's house because she sends me away far away. But over there, I enjoyed myself because it was close to the ocean and I could smell the ocean. I could enjoy the breeze up high on the mountain. So I was very happy, even though it was so far away from home. But then when my parents came for me to come to the U.S. and live in New York, I became the runaway bunny. I never liked New York, so I ran away all the way to Minnesota to go to college because, of course, I don't want them to come see me every week. I wanted to be far away, but they will come and find me. I still didn't want to go home. I still wanted to stay there after college and do all the good things that I have learned because my grandmother loves me so much that she taught me to go far away to go to school so you can concentrate and not be mingling around or running to your friend's house. And that was what I liked to do. The story of Hosea is a God source of telling the people, you can run so far away, but you cannot hide. When we turn away from the source of being our own who we are, we fail into that kind of the things that distract us from getting closer to God. No longer do we turn our eyes to God or turn our hearts to God. We turn our eyes away from God. We have lost it all when we run away from God. But we have a loving parent. When the people of Israel didn't want to return to God, God found a way to continue to love them. The divine response in our text this morning tells us of a loving parent. They do self-destructive things, but God's anger has a distinctive mercy to us all. Beyond the things that we want to accomplish, beyond the ways in which we want to live our lives, God is right there to turn us around, to call us back home. The story of the bunny running away from Mama Bernie tells us, wherever you go, whether you go into the stream, whether you climb the mountain or the tree, the Mama Bunny will come and find you. And that is the love of God to us. The people of Israel has turned away from God. They have established themselves as idol gods. But God's love never went away from them. God will find a way to help them to come home. Like the prodigal son, who, having struggled with all his bad choices, finally turns around and decided to go home. The story of the prodigal son here is the anguish, heartbreak, and the finest love of God to us. God opened God's hands to receive us when we turn ourselves around and realize that God wants us to be home. When we turn 18 years, we find a way to run away from home, far away from mom and dad, because after all, we are 18 and we are adults. Whether we're going to run away to college far away from home, or just want to establish ourselves in our own homes with our own rules that parents, mom and dad, cannot tell us what to do, God's love looks for us. Mom and dad will still find you. Whether you are 7 hours away, 10 miles away, or across the ocean, they will still come and look for you. And that is the love of God for us. So even in our greediness, our greed that tells us that we need more, our greed that reminds us of the story of this rich man who thinks that he needs more big places to store the crops, only to find out that his life can be taken away in a beat of a heart, and he will lose it all. But we have a forgiving Father, that even if we are angry, even if we are greedy, God forgives us. God reminds the people of Israel that you have turned away to the idols, to the things that is not worthy. Those things are only material things, but the riches of God is full of compassion, full of mercy, and full of love that will come and seek after you. Our failings will not be a final word. Our things that will turn away will not be the last word that we hear. But God's inner love for us knows our struggles of today. The people of Israel's future had to overcome not only when God looks for them, but a change of heart in which God loves them and unites them together with passion. The decision for the people of Israel to run away is a decision for us when we turn 18 and we want to run away from home, literally saying, we want to be under our own control roof. When we face divisions in our church today and we think the best thing for us to do is to turn away and close the doors behind us, God calls us back. God doesn't hide God's love from us. No matter how greed we may be, no matter how our anger in the time of pain and suffering, God comes back to us. God loves us so much that we can climb the mountain and God is right there to help us to climb it and help us to come down from the mountain. So Christ in all for us, that Christ will guide us back. The Paul's letter to Colossians reminds us that if Christ is in all of us, then we are all guided by the same level, by the same Spirit, larger than us all. So if Christ is in all for us, then our older ways relating to who we are can be taken away so that we can trust God more. We can put our efforts, we can put our riches in acquiring God's big love instead of God, instead of the material things in the world where we would need big places in order to store them. When we think about big places, we think about our sanctuaries. The mega churches build bigger churches so that it will be filled. We too, as Presbyterians, have built bigger churches, bigger sanctuaries. And sometimes we think that they've all run away to the mountains, to the trees, to the streams. And God is trying to get us back so that our pews will be filled again. And that is the love of God. God gave everything and more to the people of Israel, but they were not satisfied. They were filled with greed. They ran away. And yet God, as a loving parent, looked after them, sought them, had mercy, and forgave them, and brought them back to God's selves. That is our call, that we need to be sure that we save the future things for God's love, that our stewardship, our gifts that God has given to us in bountiful, it is a way for us to God to tell us that we need a balanced being. We cannot have it all. We need to share it with God. We need to share it with our neighbors. We need to remember that this parable about the things needed to be divided, God doesn't divide us. God unites us. So when we think all is lost and we have turned our other cheeks to our neighbor, we have to remember that God focused on us. No matter how greed our things acquiring will turn us away from God. These things, God calls them the idols, the things that will distract us from the word of God, from the truth of God. The man in the parable and the people that comes to share us with us, the things that lead us and help us to stay away from God, it is not the end. Our possessions will not have us. Our running away from home because we are 18 will not solve the problem of us being in control, but it is the gift of God that take us away for us to learn the things of the world and bring us back into God's self with more compassion, more ready to lead, more ready to serve, more ready to share our resources with one another. So what does it mean for us to be rich towards God? What it means is to have a loving heart, a purposeful grace to share the truth of God in us. So, when you think fall is coming and your teenagers are going to leave you, whether they run away to their friend's house, like Piper said, or they want to go to college and you wonder, when am I going to see my grandchildren and my children again? God reminds us, as a loving parent, we need to go and find them where they are. So we are not being greedy. We are forgiven people because of God's love for us. And so we go out there knowing that God's hands in our lives. God is searching for us. God is compassionate. So even when we have fallen short as a church, may we know that this is the place where God teaches us, where God reminds us that you are not dust. And dust doesn't return to any place. But God reminds us, as the Book of Common Prayer tells us, not a truth for one day in this year when we do Ash Wednesday, but the truth is the love of God in us is what makes us who we are as children of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please join me in our response to serve as we stand both body and in spirit if we are able. Affirming our faith through the brief statement of faith. In a broken and fearful world, the Spirit gives us courage to pray without ceasing, to witness among all people to Christ as Lord and Savior, to amass idolatries in churches and culture, to hear the voices of people long silenced, and to work with others for justice, freedom, and peace in gratitude to God. Empowered by the Spirit, we strive to serve Christ in our daily tasks, and to live holy and joyful lives, We, who watch for God's new heaven and new earth, praying, come, Lord Jesus. Amen. Please join with me with the hymn, Be Thou My Vision, hymn number 339. As we prepare for our prayers, are there any prayers, joys, or concerns to be shared with the community of faith? Let us now join in prayer. Loving God, we are much in need of your guidance. When we wobble and fall, stand up and help us walk again. With chorus of human kindness and bands of love, you tell us, I am to them like those who left their infants to their cheeks. And so we pray for your church and for all who teaches others with kindness, firm guidance, and love. We pray for peace among nations and peace between people. We continue to pray for peace in the war-torn Ukraine and Russia and many other places, that, Lord, your peace will reign. We pray for those suffering the scourge of heat in the West Coast. We ask you, God, who sends rains, to send rain and bring the fire and heat down. We pray for all those in need, especially women and children who suffer domestic violence and homelessness. You are the one who provides shelter, and so we ask that you be near to those who are suffering and in need of your grace and mercy. You are God of might, God of power. We live and move in our being because you are gracious to us. And so this morning, as we pray for ourselves to be returned to you with love as a loving parent, that we may endure the love that whether we feel guilty or whether we are gracious, may your guide continue to be among us, and especially those who are ill among us. And so we give you thanks that you continue to go with those who needed medical and surgical procedures. We give you thanks for Jerry Hunt. We give you thanks for Mary Jo. We give you thanks for many others that we name in our hearts that this past week went through surgical procedures. We give you thanks for the medical workers that you have gifted them with wisdom, that they are able to bring healing to many others and many of your children. We pray for the economic hardship that many are facing. With gas prices going up, with food prices going up, help us to share our resources with others, knowing that you are God who always provides for our needs. For you are the Lord who said that you will not leave us as infants without mothers. You will provide milk and honey for us. And so, Lord, we are grateful that you look over us. We are grateful that you bring us towards you. When we fall, you lift us up. And so we lift all these things to you as we come to you in the silence of our hearts with our individual intentions. And O Lord, may we find our home in the community of the Holy Spirit. May your gentle hands continue to lead and to guide us. In the name of Christ our Lord, who taught the disciples and us to pray, saying, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
As we prepare to share our gifts and ourselves in offering, we do so wherever we are, knowing that we have been freely given. Let us freely offer our gifts to the Lord.
Thank you.
Let us pray to dedicate our gifts. Holy God, we give you thanks for the riches of our lives. We ask you to bless these gifts that they might be an expression of the steadfast love you bestow into us. We pray for those in need near and far, that we may use these resources to reach out to them. We ask all this in Christ's name. Amen. So let us remember, no matter how far we run away from God, we run away from home because we may feel like we need to control and we become greedy. God's love endures. In forgiveness, God of compassion bring us together. So let us go remembering to forgive one another and unite in one another. May the love of God, the fellowship of Christ our Lord, and the power of the Holy Spirit rest upon us with peace through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yeah, I don't know why.